We're sitting here next to the Toyota Land Cruiser, and we're just going to take you through the high lift jack operation. There's a dust cover on the working mechanism of the jack, just to try and keep some of the dust out, that it works properly. It is a fairly heavy piece of equipment and it takes a lot of weight, so you must be cautious when operating it. They've just fitting the black adapter, which will fit into the rear bumper itself just to make the whole lifting operation more stable. So in order to raise the jack, there's a safety pin on the left-hand side of the jack. It must be in the down position. You can then move up the jack to the level you need it to be. It's pushed in the adapter, and now we'll need to lift the safety pin. When the safety pin is in the raised position, the jack will move upwards. And now you just carry on. You've got to go through the full 90 degrees. So you take the handle all the way up to the vertical and then back down to the horizontal, and the vehicle will raise. When you're in thick sand or mud, you need to look at the jack angle and just make sure you get a very firm footprint or positioning of the jack, the base of the jack, so that it doesn't fall over. Once the jack is in the high position and the vehicle is lifted, obviously if you needed to change wheel, you would go through that procedure. Or if you're stuck in the sand, you've now lifted the vehicle up, can fill in the hole, and then you come to having to lower the vehicle and lower the jack. In order to do that, you've got to put the safety pin into the lower position. Now, the reason that Dixon has used his foot there is you want to be a little bit careful about just getting your finger in and around the mechanism of the high lift. So it is safer, just make sure you're away from the lever, and you know, you can use your foot, or just be careful when you use your finger to push it down. Now when you go through the full 90 degrees of the handle going up and lowering down, it should then drop the vehicle. And you would just go down until the weight of the vehicle is back on the suspension, and then you can remove the jack. We're going to have a look at some of the recovery gear that we supply with our vehicles. Anytime you're traveling remote and you're in 4x4 terrain, you may well need to use some of this equipment. We're going to start with the high lift jack, which is probably your most important piece of equipment. Whether you need to change a tire and you're in sand or mud terrain or uneven terrain, or if you're stuck in the sand or mud, the high lift jack is essential. The vehicle's got the bull bar fitted in the front with a place for the high lift jack to fit in. You can lift the front of the vehicle, so if you need to change the front right wheel, you'd be lifting it up, or if the front right wheel is dug into the sand, you now need to lift it to cover that hole in order to get yourself out. You can now take the rubber sand ladder. You've covered up the hole using the spade. You would then take the rubber sand ladder and you can actually place it under the wheel. And you can then lower the vehicle. The vehicle's now going to be sitting higher, so we've actually raised the belly of the vehicle off the sand, which means the weight is now transferred onto the wheel again. And when we come to driving off, you're now going to have traction. Of course, if you're in the sand, you would have lowered your tire pressures. You can go down as low as 1.0 bar. The wheels, the tire is going to be bulging out, but you're going to get a lot more traction on the sand. Okay, we'll now show you the air compressor. In the case you've had to lower your tire pressure to get out of the sand and you now need to pump it up before you go back onto bitumen or tar road, we supply an air compressor which allows you to be able to pump your own wheel up if you need to puncture or if you need to raise the tire pressure. You can connect the power of the air compressor to the second battery so that it doesn't drop the power on the main battery. It's a high volume compressor, so it should pump the wheel up in about 15 to 20 minutes. The next item we're going to have a look at is the grass seed net. Now, the grass seed net is not always needed, but at certain times of the year, in the summer months, you may get a lot of grass seed on the 4x4 tracks. In Southern Africa, it's normally between late October, November through to March, April. And if you do find you're seeing a lot of grass seed, you need to fit the grass seed net. This will prevent the seed from getting through the grill and clogging up against the radiator. If you don't fit the grass seed net, there's a good chance that you're going to end up with a clogged radiator and it can lead to an overheating problem. If you end up with an overheated engine under those sort of circumstances, you're completely liable for it. So it's very important to use the grass seed net. While we're talking about the clogging of radiators, there is another risk when you're driving off-road and you need to drive through water crossings or mud holes where you may get quite a lot of mud in the water. It can also clog up against the radiator, and when it dries, it can cause a serious overheating problem. The grass seed net's primary function is not for that, but it may also assist if you have no choice but to drive through those sort of puddles. Otherwise, you need to avoid mud wherever possible. If you do have to drive through the mud, then you need to rinse and wash the car off as best possible and clean the radiator before you carry on. Again, you will be liable for any damage, so you need to monitor it after those sort of conditions. Just a few additional items that we supply with the vehicles. There is a complete toolbox in case you need to do some work on the vehicle. There's a high lift jack adapter, tow strap, puncture repair kit, just to mention a few, and these items will occasionally be needed. Where the vehicles are booked for long-term rentals, where you'll be out for longer and possibly doing more mileage, we also supply a service kit, which will be basic service items plus fan belts, possibly wheel bearings, those sort of things that you may need along the route. Those service items can be fitted or used at any workshop, but it is recommended to use a qualified or an approved workshop to carry on with any sort of major mechanical repairs. But in a lot of these outlying areas, they may not have stock of parts, and you have the comfort of knowing you're carrying some of the stuff with you.